You can use the command line interface or SDK to import annotations in any of our supported file formats. We currently support the formats COCO, YOLO, Pascal, VOC, and more, but we are always looking to extend this list. That said, the default and most versatile format is our own Darwin JSON format, so let's have a brief look at how it is defined. The content of each Darwin JSON file can be summarized by the following specifications. An export includes all the information about the exported resource. The most important information hereby are the item and annotations field. The dataset field simply encodes the Darwin dataset name that the resource belongs to. The slots field again describes a resource that can be of type image or video uploaded to Darwin, including its original metadata. The version field will simply be 2.0 when the export format is Darwin JSON 2.0. Now, the item field includes information about the referenced resource, that is the image or the video uploaded to Darwin within particular slots. And finally, the annotations field actually lists all the annotations within Darwin for that resource, be it bounding boxes or polygons. Outside of the annotation data, the only really required field in the imports for Darwin JSON is the file name. That is used to associate the annotations to the corresponding images in V7 upon import. But okay, enough boring definitions, let's look at some code. As you can see, we have already uploaded the images in our dataset to V7, but we now want to also upload our existing annotations using the SDK. Let's first see how to access our datasets that are stored on V7 using the command line interface. If we haven't already, we need to authenticate ourselves using the command Darwin authenticate, where we'll be asked to enter our API key. Those can be found and generated when going to our settings in V7 and then to the tab for API keys. Now that we are authenticated, we can view which datasets we have by entering Darwin datasets remote. We now have everything that we need to actually import our annotations. The easiest method to do so is using the command line interface. We simply use the commands Darwin dataset import and provide the following arguments. First, we specify the slugified team and dataset names. If the term slugified is new to you, please have a look at documentation and everything should be clear. Okay, the missing important arguments are the annotation format and the path to the annotations themselves. And that's actually it. Now, using the SDK is really not much more work. Let's have a look at the simple scripts to upload our annotations. We again start by initializing our client, where there are multiple ways of doing so. For example, directly via the API key, or using the local authentication that we just set up when using the command line interface. We there also figured out the dataset identifier that we can now use to target the dataset in V7. Next, we need to specify the annotation format, and we can fetch the necessary parser object. Finally, we can upload our annotations to our dataset hosted on V7. Oh, and this append argument here specifies whether an already existing annotation will be overwritten or not. That means setting append to true will add the imported annotation without overriding the existing ones. Okay, cool. Let's see the script in action. Okay, we have already looked at this dataset right here and know that we have some annotations here, for example those with the green mark are in the complete stage, and that some images don't have annotations. For example, this little image right here of this nightingale. So let's go ahead and look at the code and upload the annotation that I have already done and have stored on my local machine. So we'll go ahead and look at the code. Okay, as with every script that we write, we first need to import our dependencies. And while going through the code, we'll look at what each individual module actually does. So let's go ahead and import our dependencies. We now are at the point where we want to authenticate our client, right? We need to somehow have an interface to V7 itself. And there are multiple ways of doing so. For example, one is to directly use your API key, or the other is to, as already discussed, use the local authentication method, which we have set up when using the command line interface. Right, the code is already familiar to you, we already looked at it, but let's just see how it works in action. So now we are at the point where we want to specify our dataset. Our dataset is our team name, our slugified team name, Boris Moinados, that's me, and then the dataset that we are working with. So when we run this, we actually get access to our remote dataset and we have our dataset manager. So let's run this cell. Now going through the code step by step, we now want to get our parser object that we need for our importer. Therefore, we'll just specify our format name. In my case, we are again using the nice Darwin JSON format. So let's just run the cell and fetch our parser object. And then we need to specify the list of annotations that we have. Now, in this case, I'll just be showing you how to upload one annotation, but you can always append this list with all the paths to all the annotations that you have and that you want to upload to V7. So again, in this case, I have my annotations path, which is a list of just strings with the path to this one annotation that I have. Right, if you look at how the annotations look like, I can go into my bird species, which has all the images, and then I go to my releases and to my annotations, and I here have my list with all annotations. Okay, so let's just create this little list, and we are almost done. Okay, and we can now simply use our importer object to actually import the annotations. We hereby again specify to which dataset we want to import our annotations to. We provide our parser, which is now set to be for the Darwin JSON file format. We have our list of annotations and our just discussed append true argument. So let's just run the cell. And we can see that we are already done. It's just one file. So let's go ahead and look at our UI. This is the image that we want to upload our annotation to. Let's just refresh this website. And you can see here we have the annotation. If I just reduce the brightness, you can see the annotation even better. And that's it. It's as simple as that. Again, not that crazy, right? You now know how to import your existing annotations into V7. I hope this video helped you with getting started with, well, V7.